This student found it important to make a radio with which we could all enjoy our favorite music.
Good morning, my name is Jisoo Kim. Welcome to my company presentation. My project consists of a radio program called Pop Prince Radio, and the ANS core value guided by my project is innovation and creativity. I began my project with an initial objective to increase unity amongst our community by showcasing and encouraging by promoting more diversity already present at our school. Since young, I used to be interested in media, how it allows people easier communication, and my passion naturally followed. I decided to use radio as the mechanism to achieve my purpose because I really liked some features of Korean radios, which I decided to adapt and implement as key elements in my radio. The core value, as previously mentioned, is innovation and creativity. Pop Prince Radio, the project itself, can be considered as an innovation. It's a very novel idea. There has never been a radio at our school that is not related to news-related features. And creativity is involved in every component of the radio, which I consider very important because it's directly related to entertainment as well. Essential skills I developed throughout my project are organizational skills and attitude towards work. As I mentioned, one of my passion is media, and my attitude towards work followed my passion. I worked very hard. I put so much effort into this project, and I'm pretty sure Mr. Quinones knows about this. He can prove this. And organizational skills were highly required in my project because it deals with so many components, and in order to make them as one, I really needed to organize myself. Adaptability, I developed a skill when I adapted some ideas from Korean radios and implemented and made it suitable, adjusted for our school. Time management is very important because radio equals consistency. In order to maintain this consistency, I had to make sure I managed my time well and sent all the episodes beforehand with sufficient time. Collaborative skills, I worked with technology department and Ms. Lori, Ms. LePay, and other mentors. Ms. LePay helped me with the journalism and all. And since we belong to different bodies, but we all had to work together as one under the same purpose, under the same objective to launch my radio and to make it successful, collaborative skills were required. And I developed them. Information literacy and research. I conducted research. I researched every time I wrote on script for an episode every week in order to make it creative and entertaining. And communication, my radio itself is a communication. Verbal communication by the speaker, written communication by the script writer, and presented through the playing of the radios every Monday through the school PA system. Statistics on the demand. How did I know if the students had an interest in the implementation of my project at all? So I conducted this survey before I would launch my Pop Prince Radio. I asked, would you want a radio program where you can share your stories and request music? I specified when it would be played and how. Who answered my survey? I used stratified sampling. So I received a list of students, all secondary students, from each grade, and I divided them by stratas, which is each grade. I did simple random sampling for each strata and chose 10 students. So in total of 70 students received the survey. I had 17 non-responses, but since I used random sample, I can infer about the whole population. Here's the distribution of who answered my survey, and you can see that's pretty much equally distributed. The results were as the following. 8 answered no and 45 answered yes. So 84.9% answering yes means that there is a somewhat high demand for my radio, so which gave me a hint to proceed with my plan. Product intended and achieved. Luckily, I was able to achieve my product, my original scheme of the product without any major adjustments. So my radio's name is Pop Prince Radio. The components are as the following: introduction statement, first request a song, a story shout out, problems that students send to be shared, second request a song, and closing sentence. All the episodes followed this format since these toward like the main central focus, story sharing and song request. And these were played every Monday from 6:40 a.m. to 6:55 a.m. Here are some of my process I took. From August to November 2019, I brainstormed, planned, met with my mentors. So I basically prepared for the launch of Paw Prince Radio. From January to March 2020, I played the radio every Monday from 6:45 to 6:55 a.m. And I also created a promotion video that would encourage students and teachers and staff members and individuals of our community, so basically the audience, to participate more. From April to May 2020, I implemented Paw Prince Radio as a project under Journalism for Sustainability so that it could continue even after I leave. I also created a guide for this radio crew that I was going to make in journalism. And I even visited journalism class to talk with the students to encourage them to join. So here are some evidence to the meetings with my mentors. I had 5 mentors in total: Ms. LePay, Ms. Lori, Ms. Selma Blandon, and 2 off-campus mentors, Soyeon Jang and Yong Jujin, who are students in Korean schools who have a role in the broadcasting team of their schools. And they taught me about how Korean radios functioned, and that's where I adopted my ideas. Here are some evidence with each meeting I had with the mentors, some notes I took, and overall, furthermore, I had more meetings, so I constantly communicated with Ms. Lori to receive feedback from the school administration, from the teachers, and from the students in general. She helped me throughout the whole year. Here are the results of my work. Here's the evidence. I've been sending an email a week before with the audio file already edited and of the radio episode a week before the Monday it was going to be played, so that the technology department had enough time to play them and put them in the system. Here's the evidence of the whole emails I've been sending constantly. Here's the promotion video I created. I'm going to be playing it. Oh no, I can't play it. Sorry, it can't be played when it's... Oh no, it can be played. Yes, so this was the promotion video I created to encourage more participation. This video was shared on Instagram page of Eye of the Tiger and Humans of Aness, which I have both access to. And I also asked some teachers like Mr. Quinones and Ms. LePay to play this video during their class so that students would watch them and participate, requesting songs and sharing stories. Why is my project important to ANS and how can the community support it? First of all, I believe my Paw Prince Radio promotes more unity and diversity in our community, which is my initial objective. I can confidently say that I achieved my purpose. How do I know this, and how do I know Paw Prince Radio impact these individuals? I asked one teacher and one student to give me feedback, to comment about Paw Prince Radio, and overall they were very optimistic. I could see that they constantly mention the diversity of music they get to experience, culture diversity. They get to listen to songs that they didn't know before. And the student even mentioned that she was excited every Monday to know the chosen song to be played and the chosen story to be shared. And overall, she felt very close to the community she belonged to. So this proves that I achieved my purpose. How can the school help? How can the school support? How can the community support? Actively participate, send requests to play your favorite songs, and share your stories via radio@ans.edu.me. I really encourage you guys to do so. Thank you for watching my presentation, and hope you have a great day.
In order to make this a cornerstone of our school, make sure to participate, send in your favorite songs, and listen to them in the morning.